Hello and welcome back to Cloveriness. My name is Michelle, and today I wanted to talk to you about Obsidian by Jennifer L. Armentrout. Obsidian and the Lux series is definitely both a book and a series that is well loved by booktubers as well as book bloggers, and I have read and watched quite a few of your blog posts and videos gushing and raving about this story, these characters, and definitely this relationship that crops up within this book. And it was definitely these blog posts and videos that made me curious to see what I would think about this book. So I did download it on my Kindle a few months ago, I believe, and recently I did pick up my Kindle and decide to read it. Now, despite the fact that I read it and finished it in the same day, it was not a book that I was overly enthusiastic about while I was reading it. I only rated it 3 stars on Goodreads, and unfortunately it's not a book that I will be recommending that other people pick up, and it's not a series that I will continue to read. Now, one of the things that I did like about the book is Katie, the main character's book blogging. I really loved that this hobby that I do, that a lot of people do, was being mentioned in such a cool way within the book. I loved that she talked about waiting on Wednesday and in my mailbox, and I loved how much her passion and enthusiasm for books and for reading came through within the pages of this story. That's definitely something that I really, really enjoyed about this book. But there are 3 things in particular that became more and more annoying throughout the book. First annoyance that I had was the character names. I had no problem with Katie's name whatsoever. It's her love interest, and throughout, you know, my experience of reading Obsidian, I chose to pretend that in fact his name was Damon as opposed to Demon, because Demon as a name is so ridiculous that I couldn't even bear to... I couldn't do it. It made me roll my eyes, it made me cringe a little bit, thinking, you know, okay, yes, this boy's name is Demon. If you're not familiar with this story, it's the story of Katie and her mother who leave Florida and they go to stay in this other place. They end up in this pokey little town somewhere after the death of Katie's father from cancer, and they end up being next door neighbors to this really good looking boy and his really friendly sister, Damon, and his sister Dee, who are twins. Okay, and Katie's mother is really pushing Katie into making friends and getting out there and getting involved, and so Katie goes over, knocks on their door to say, look, can you help me find the nearest grocery store? And she meets this guy who is drop dead gorgeous. He comes to the door and he's shirtless and all of this sort of ripped body type thing, and woo! He's such an asshole at the start of the story and throughout the story that at no point in their relationship, especially towards the beginning, did I think, wow, yes, I could really see myself falling for him. I don't have a problem with bad boys in general. I don't have a problem with attitude or anything, but I really, really found myself loathing Damon's character just because he's not very nice. And while we can see a softer side to Damon, especially in his relationship with his sister Dee, there was just too much about him that I just didn't find myself fancying at all. And it's Damon's character that made me dislike the book more and more. I did like that Katie did try to stick up for herself. She ended up being a lot stronger of a character as the book went on, but first of all, I don't like his douchey behavior at all. There were times, especially when he humiliates Katie in the cafeteria at school, that I just thought, why are you bothering with this? While I did enjoy Katie's reaction in moments to the cafeteria scene, I felt like all of her anger and wrath was pointed at another character and not at Damon himself. Second thing besides his unlikable behavior is that he's very much one of those characters in books that tells our main character, you know, I would tell you all of these things, but I don't think that you're ready for it. I don't think that you could handle it, type of thing. And I really, really hate those and that type of behavior, this concealment of information, especially for your own good, really pisses me off something awful, especially because Katie's life is put into danger because of the information that she doesn't know. And obviously I think her behavior would have changed had she known earlier on all of the things that she was getting into. So that was strike number two. The third thing about Damon's character himself is how overpowering he is. I really, really hate this whole thing about how he can't be with Katie because it puts Dee's safety, her life, in danger. And what he is doing by imposing these rules or whatever is that Damon is taking these choices away from Dee. I think that if Dee were given the choice of having a normal friendship and a normal life and at the same time being in slightly more danger, I think that she would definitely choose that option rather than the option that Damon chooses for her, which is to keep her safe by closing the pair of them off from everyone else and separating them from the other humans. And I said that there were three things that made me dislike Damon's character, and I lied! There was actually four, and the fourth thing is that Damon really blows hot and cold in his relationship with Katie. He likes being around her, he wants to spend time with her one day, and then the next day, he changes his mind and she's left feeling really uncertain and she loses sort of confidence in herself, not knowing how mercurial Damon is going to be about their relationship that day. And I really hate it. I don't appreciate this sort of drama-led relationships where it's on a little a roller coaster with their ups and their downs and their fighting and their making up or whatever. I don't like it. There might be something more boring about consistency and about niceness. Can I say I would much prefer somebody who is nice, somebody who is consistent over Katie and Damon? So those are my main thoughts, anyway, on Obsidian by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I'm sure that lots of you have read this series. Let me know what you think about my thoughts on the book. I would love to hear from you. And thank you again for watching.